Good morning. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Hallelujah.
We are welcoming everyone who is joining us on Facebook this morning, as well as this full congregation this morning. What a beautiful witness of faith that we bring to worship together today. It is Mother's Day, and all of us have mothers, so we have something to be very grateful for. So happy Mother's Day to all of our mothers and all who serve as mothers to this world. You're going to hear a little more about that today, and I thought it was interesting that the word mother is Latin for, or in Latin is mater, and it's alma mater. And if this is ringing a bell for any high school graduate, I hope you know your alma mater. And this is also high school recognition for our graduates this Sunday. I thought it was just perfect timing to bring that little tidbit. Mater means mother, nourishing mother. And how beautiful it is that we have God who sets the example of this love to worship today. So with all of those celebrations in our hearts, and God here waiting to hear our praises, let's stand and worship. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the wellspring of grace, our Easter, and our joy.
Amen.
Look, here is water.
Here is our water of life. Hallelujah.
In the promises of baptism, let us give thanks for what God has done for us. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your voice thundered over the deep, and water became the essence of life. Adam and Eve beheld Eden's verdant rivers. The ark carried your creation through the flood into a new day. Miriam led the dancing as your people passed through the sea into freedom's land. In a desert pool, the Ethiopian official entered your boundless baptismal life. Look, here is water.
Here is our water of life. Hallelujah.
At the river, your beloved son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you opened the floodgates of your reconciling love, freeing us to live as Easter people. We rejoice with glad hearts, giving all honor and praise to you through the risen Christ, our source of living water, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Look. Here is water.
Here is our water of life.
And on the seventh Sunday of Easter, we say Alleluia, because God sent his son to be resurrected from that grave so that we can live eternally. So sing with open hearts today as we glorify.
Thank you.
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Please join me in the prayer of the day. Let us pray. Gracious and glorious God, you have chosen us as your own, and by the powerful name of Christ, you protect us from evil. By your Spirit, transform us in your beloved world, that we may find our joy in your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit. One God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated.
The first reading is from Acts, the first chapter. In those days, Peter stood up among the believers, together the crowd numbered about 120 persons, and said, "Friends, the scripture has to be fulfilled, which the Holy Spirit through David foretold concerning Judas, who became a guide for those who arrested Jesus. For he was numbered among us and was allotted his share in his ministry. So one of the men who had accompanied us during the time that the Lord Jesus went in and out among us, beginning from the baptism of John until the day when he was taken up from us, one of these must become a witness with us to his resurrection. So they proposed two, Joseph called Barsabbas, who was also known as Judas, and Matthias. Then they prayed and said, Lord, you know everyone's heart. Show us which one of these you have chosen to take the place in the ministry, an apostleship from Judas turned aside to go to his own place. And they cast lots for them, and the lot fell on Matthias, and he was added to the 11 apostles. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
We will read responsively the psalm found in your bulletin. Happy are they who have not walked in the counsel of the wicked, nor lingered in the way of the sinners, nor sat in the seats of the mournful. They delight us in the law of the Lord, and they meditate on God's teaching day and night. They are like trees planted by streams and water, bearing fruit in due season with leaves that do not wither. Everything they do shall prosper. It is not so with the wicked. They are like the chaff which the wind blows away. Therefore, the wicked shall not stand upright when judgment comes, nor the sinner in the counsel of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked shall be destroyed. The second reading is from John, or 1 John, the 5th chapter. If we receive human testimony, the testimony of God is greater. For this is the testimony of God, that he has testified to his Son. Those who believe in the Son of God have the testimony in their hearts. Those who do not believe in God may have made him a liar by not believing in the testimony of God that has given concerning his Son. And this is the testimony. God gave us eternal life, and life is in the Son. Whoever has the Son of life, whoever does not have the Son of life, does not have life. I write these things to you, believe in the name of the Son of God, so that you may know that you have eternal life. Word of God, word of life.
I invite the children down. Good morning. How are all of you today? Boy, that sunlight is surely shining in those windows this morning. Oh, why, thank you. Whoa, I moved it too quickly. Thank you. Well, why don't you gather around right in front of me so I can face the congregation as I'm trying to teach you this. Well, hello, Nora. If you feel comfortable sitting down, or if you need to sit on the sides, go right ahead, wherever you want to be. Okay. I would like you to identify what you think this is. A flashlight, yes. What is the purpose of a flashlight? Yes, so you can find things, right? To search. Why is it not doing that? What have I not done? Oh, you have to hit the button. What happens when I hit that button? The light will turn on. So what is giving it power? Yes, it's a little bit of me, and there's something inside. Yep, it's a battery. Okay, so are you ready? It's going to work. It's a big scientific experiment. Here we go. Is it on? Do you all, did I shine it in? Okay, let me shine it on your shoes there. Oh, there's some sparkly shoes up here. There we go. Yep. So I can find things better when I have the light. Is that agreeable? Is that safe to say? And that is exactly what Jesus is telling us today in the gospel. You will see things better if you have me in your life. You will understand where to search and where to go and where to look. But I need you to be the light. So you guys are all like flashlights to Jesus. You are this. And when you push the button and you say, I need charged up, God, God makes that light shine through you. When you were baptized, there was a verse read that said, let your light so shine before others so they can see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. I am going to show Tegan's shoes. Do you see that glitter, how it shines even brighter? That's what happens when you glorify God in heaven. It is just the most beautiful thing. It's transcendent. That's a word we don't use very often, but there's nothing that can come in between that light of God and you. It cannot be contaminated. That's really the beautiful thing of light and why God uses that word light. We have light on the candles. We always have worship with light. And on our Paschal candle, which is right here, that's always the light of the church, of what is going on right here at Good Hope Lutheran Church. That candle is unique to us because it shines when it's Easter. So It also shines when there are baptisms and when there are funerals. It's always about life. So light and life go together, and that is the message. So today, you have people that have shown you the light. We call them mothers. They show you the way. Sometimes they really shine that light and say, this is where you need to look. Like when you can't find your socks or shoes in the mornings, or if you didn't do your homework, or you didn't brush your teeth, or they want to make sure you're doing things right. All of you have that responsibility. It is what God gives us and our gifts to shine in this world. So this week, look for the light, shine it, get charged by Christ, and glorify him with all of your good works. Let's say a prayer. Dear Jesus, thank you for being our light.
Thank you for being our light.
May we reflect that light, and glorify you.
Amen.
Amen. Please stand for the gospel acclamation. According to St. John, the 17th chapter, verses 6 through 19. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus prayed, I have made your name known to those whom you gave me from the world. They were yours, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now they know that everything you have given me is from you. For the words that you gave to me, I have given to them, and they have received them, and know in truth that I came from you, and they have believed that you sent me. I am asking on their behalf. I am not asking on behalf of the world, but on behalf of those whom you gave me, because they are yours. All mine are yours, and yours are mine, and I have been glorified in them. And now I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, protect them in your name that you have given me so that they may be one as we are one. While I was with them, I protected them in your name that you have given me. I guarded them, and not one of them was lost except the one destined to be lost, so that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you, and I speak these things in the world so that they may have my joy made complete in themselves. I have given them your word, and the world has hated them because they do not belong to the world, just as I do not belong to the world. I am not asking you to take them out of the world, but I ask you to protect them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world, just as I do not belong to the world. Sanctify them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you have sent me into this world, so I have sent them into the world. And for their sakes, I sanctify myself so that they also may be sanctified in truth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
You may be seated.
Buried him.
Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, who advocates for us. Amen. It is the seventh Sunday of Easter. The white banners will be coming down, and next week it is Pentecost, where the Holy Spirit comes down and gives us that powerful Holy Spirit that stirs us. It is a joyous time in the calendar of the church. And I'm so glad you're here today. I went to a couple of graduation things because my grandson, my oldest grandson, is also graduating. And I was inspired so much by the words that were spoken at the signing day. They quoted a principal from years past, and she ended every announcement with ILMJ. And I had to wonder what that meant. And the girl that was speaking about it said it was so corny. Every day that principal would get on those announcements and she would say, I love ILMJ. And it meant I love my job. And she goes, I didn't realize until I was older and out of school what she was saying to us. And I just wanted to start today by saying, ILMC, I love my call. I love my congregation. And I hope these words bring you joy, because that is Jesus' words to us today. As you know, I was a teacher for 30 years, and that schedule of class, I taught at high school most of the time. 42 minutes, the bell would ring, and everything about your life was divided in those 42 minutes. You knew how to get them into your classroom, how to get their attention, and then when it came May of doing that every single day and knowing these people that were sitting in front of you so well, I had a routine that I loved doing. I taught choir, and so for the last 8 minutes, of every class from April to May, we would sing songs that would send them out into this world and bind us together forever. And a few of those were from the song Seasons of Love. 525,600 minutes. That's what we have in a year's time. 525,600 minutes, every single one of us has that equal amount of time. And we get to choose what we're going to do with it. When people say, I don't have time to do that, they have the same amount of time as everybody else. It's the choices that you make. And the song goes on, remember the love. Every part of your life is to remember the love. And if you can keep a little love in all of those 525,600 minutes, you're going to understand Jesus' words about joy. The next song we would sing would be called Good Riddance. It's not a very good title, but it's the time of your life. Remember the time of your life. Now, these aren't only for the graduates, but it's to every single one of us. We only have this life. It is not a dress rehearsal. And so when you are doing your daily routines, remember, this is yours. It belongs to you that you get to share it. Along with those memories of love. And then every single day for 8 weeks, we would end the class with Michael W. Smith's Friends Are Friends Forever If the Lord's the Lord of Them. And they never got tired of it because they realized this is the one time that these people would be together. And you know, as we all get older, we remember those times. They change quickly. Today is the only day that all of us will be together right here at this moment. And so we are together in Christ forever. It's a beautiful way to look at life. And I love that structure. Everybody expected it. Everybody participated in it. I'm not sure they all loved it, but I am sure after being out of teaching, they remember it. I hear their stories, just like they talked about that principle that ended every announcement with ILMJ. The imprint of the heart is important. It is ours to do here in this world while we are here. And the power to do it is from the light above. And that is why I just truly love John 17. If there's a chapter in the Bible I could just take out and it says everything about Jesus to me, it is this chapter. You see, Jesus is getting ready to go to the cross. And he is trying to tell his disciples who he loved so much. Remember this. And then he even talks to his father. So this is a prayer that Jesus is praying for his disciples at that time. He's praying it for himself, and he is most definitely praying it for the future. Jesus prayed for all of us that we would have this moment in time to remember the love that he brings to us from the Father. Jesus modeled this divine structure, this divine schedule, just like what you've experienced in your life. You know, the mornings are what you do. There's a bell that clicks and you go to somewhere else. And when you don't have that structure, it kind of throws you off your pattern. And Jesus is telling us right here, it's important to have structure in your life. Know where you go to get fed, to be nourished. His first act in John 17 is to glorify his Father, to do his will. He goes, Father, I have come to earth. You have sent me. I have told all of them about you, and they believe me. They know that you sent me. That takes you all the way back on Christmas Eve. Who sends this little baby? It was God the Father because he loved you so much. And he goes, I have walked with them. I am going to the cross. They don't yet understand what this will be, but they will, because I know that you will show them the truth. Jesus, the entire time he lived on earth in a circle of light. He showed everybody around him the love, the mercy, the forgiveness that comes to us from being a child of God. That character of God radiates through him, and we can't help but reflect it when we are his children. That's the glory they're talking about, because it gets a little confusing. You are mine, I am yours. It's we are one. We're in the glory of Christ. Now, I got you all into exactly what Jesus is praying, but this is the point I want you to hear today, especially graduates. Light. God sends us light. And what does that mean? He says, live in the light. Well, light is transcendent. And that's a word you don't usually hear very often, but it means nothing can contaminate it. What in this life cannot be contaminated? Light shines above us, and what a witness we had with the Northern Lights here in Ohio. That is all from God. And he shines it above us every day. Light diffuses the darkness. And you are called to be that light. You are called to radiate that character of God in your life so that wherever you go, in the most unpredictable seasons of your life, you will be able to shine that light to a world that desperately needs it. And when you shine your light, others will shine it back. Light illuminates our understanding of the Holy Spirit. One of my teachers always said this about the church. He said, the Holy Spirit is always looking over his shoulder, looking at the church to see, can you catch up? I like that idea. There's someone leading us, looking over the shoulder and saying, why can you not see what is right in front of you for you to do? God is waiting for you to shine that light. Know that you're never alone. God is right out there. And he's shining right on to you and the people that he wants you to know. Take every moment to know that. And most of all, light just brings warmth and comfort. What beautiful things to think about that God is telling us through his son, Jesus Christ, to his disciples, to us today. Shine the light, be the light. It's that simple. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. You learned it when you were little, and we should sing it every morning when we wake up. Because God loves us so much, he knows that's what we're gonna need. Jesus prays that we would stay together in this light, unity. Not unified, uniformity, but in unity that we would all know that we are God's children. And nothing will divide us from that. There is only prayer that can keep us unified to Jesus and to each other, prayer that we are one in Christ. And we pray that over and over. We worship as one in Christ. And we realize Christ reaches so many places farther than we could ever see. As we are doing that, Jesus prays that our joy can be complete. I've really wondered what that means, joy complete. I mean, I can be joyous. I found joy in sorrow. I found joy in my life when things weren't in my favor. But what does it mean to be complete? I think these are questions you need to ask yourself. What does it mean to be completely in joy in Jesus Christ? And that is just total trust, total commitment. Just as we sign away our life on contracts and everything else, Jesus says, sign on to being a believer in Christ forever. Your joy is complete when you do that. I will send this protection and seal you with the Holy Spirit, and I will set you apart And it's a really churchy word when we say God sanctifies us. What it just means is you are now his witnesses. You are holy. He has set you apart, and now it's all up to you. And so the church matters. God matters in your life. The church matters in your life. And where are you going to witness? I am always surprised to hear stories. People tell me stories all the time of things that have happened in their life and how God has been there in those moments. And of course, being the musical nerd, I always loved watching shows and things that really show witness. And I was introduced to a musical I have not yet seen because it's off Broadway right now. It's called Witness Uganda, or it was called The Invisible Thread. What would I want to know about Uganda? Except it's a story we all need to hear. There was this young man, Griffin Matthews, who went to church in New York City, and he served in that church, but the church didn't like him. And he was not happy that his church didn't like him, so he was looking for other ways to serve. So he found a mission trip to Uganda. And everything he wanted to do in Uganda was just to make a difference, and he thought it would make his life so much better. And when he got there, the mission trip wasn't at all what he thought it should be. In fact, it wasn't what he thought was God-centered. And somehow he ended up hanging out with a group of destituted, orphaned teenagers who were angry with the world. The world had dealt them such terrible patterns for their life. No one to love them, no one to care. And he said, I spent every single day for 6 weeks talking to these young teenagers, and then I came back to New York City and knew I was going to change the world. He goes, I never really knew if it was possible, but he thought he had a plan. So he wrote this musical, and every profit that comes from that musical, beyond what expenses were, goes to a school for those teenagers in Uganda. And he went over and taught them. And he taught them that in order to have a great life, you have to give. And he said, go out into this world and be the light. This beautiful song that says, is this what love is? Opening hearts, laying your weapons down. Our weapons of judgment, of insecurities, of fear, just seeing people as people. He said, I've changed myself, I've changed my life, and it's so beautiful to live in this light. Opening hearts, making sure that God's light is shining everywhere you go, using the gifts that God has given you, and every single one of you has a gift that God has intended for you to share. So in the next 525,600 minutes, I would love to hear your testimony of your witness that you have shined that light, not only for the graduates, but for everyone here, because God is watching, and he is living right here in eternal life today, because he loves you. Amen.
Thank you.
invite the congregation to be seated and for the graduates with their parents to come forward. It is so wonderful to have you all here today. And of course, you can come right up to the rail. Kenna Caldwell, Ryan McMichael is not with us right now. Trinity Pelfrey, Lily Piper, and Ivy Schiffer are our graduates for this year from Good Hope. Let us pray. God of power and life, thank you for the gift of these graduates. Continue to touch each and every young person here that they may know you, love them, and guide them no matter where life leads. May every graduate here reflect on the journey you have walked with them, through the victories and defeats, the joys and the sorrows, the time you drew them close and comforted them and helped them get where they are today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Now I ask the graduates to please kneel on the railing here and for the parents to be behind them and put your hands on their shoulders or head as we do this. This is the prayer for the parents. Almighty God, with a parent's love and care, you have blessed these parents with the joy and the responsibility of these graduates. You have been with them as they have raised their son or daughter to this stage of their life. We know that as they raised their child, you were there with your gracious love to comfort them. You were there with your wisdom to guide them, and you were there with your mercy to forgive them. We give thanks for all that you have done, Lord. We pray in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Now, I mark you with the anointing oil. Every time you are marked with an anointing oil, it's to remind you that you are God's child. Kenna, God bless you in this life passage for you. Amen.
It's okay if I spring you with baptism on her.
Trinity, may God bless you in this life passage that God has for you.
I sprinkle you with baptism on her.
Lily, may God bless you in this life passage that God has for you. Amen.
I sprinkle you with baptism on her.
And now you may stand and face the congregation, and let's give them an encouraging sign of approval and love here from Good Hope. That's an applause. And we have these microphones right here. We want to know what your plans are. So I'm not sure I can get them out, but you're there you go.
I'm graduating from Bucyrus High School, and I'm attending Marion Technical College to study sonography.
Trinity, I may have you just come over here.
I'm graduating from Northmore High School, and I'm going to continue like performing arts things.
I'm graduating from Wimford, and I'm attending Marion Technical College to study radiology.
Our prayers are with you, and this is always home. And we have gifts from the congregation for you, cards signed at our Mission Sunday. And always know, whenever you need anything, we are right here, and God's always right there. Peace be with you. You may go back to your seats, and everyone, please stand for the creed.
Let us confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son,
Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. At the right hand of the Father, he will come to judge the living and the dead. Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated for the prayers. Rejoicing that Jesus is risen and love has triumphed over fear, let us pray for the church, the world, and all those in need of good news. You sanctify us in your truth. Your word is truth. Send your church out into the world to spread your love and joy. Embolden all bishops, pastors, and deacons to be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments. Your creation groans under the strain of pollution. Preserve melting glaciers and dwindling forest. Bolster those who work for climate justice and help us all to be good and faithful stewards of your creation. Your people seek wisdom, understanding, and peace. Guide all those who govern and inspire them to work on behalf of the most vulnerable in our midst. Keep safe first responders, those serving in the military, and those whose duty it is to protect others. Your children need your loving care. Protect them from all harm. Comfort those in any affliction. We lift up in prayer Marge, Heidi, Keith, Bruce, Sydney, Nyla, Sean, Kathy, Ray, Joni, Ernie, Kendall, Terry, Frank, John, Cooper, Barb, Melissa, Roseanne, Amanda, Bill, and Tim. Support those who grieve and bring solace to those near death. Your spirit lives within us here. Inspire the work of this congregation and unite us as one. Bless all the mothers in our midst, console those for whom this day is difficult, and gather us all under the care of your loving wings. Your saints dwell with you in light. Keep us ever thankful for those who have gone before us in faith. Inspire us by their witness.
Lord, please be with the families that grieve of the loss of their loved one, the family of Huck Howard, the families and friends of Margaret Thornton, and the family and friends of Charlie Dirkscheide. Lord, we celebrate today for the life that you give to us, and we are praying for our graduates throughout our county, throughout our state, throughout our nation, that they may find that you are the source of all power and love and purpose. We pray especially for Kenna, Ryan, Trinity, Lily, and Ivy. Into your hands, most merciful God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your abiding love through Jesus Christ, our resurrected and living Lord. Amen.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Share the peace of the Lord.
Thank you.
Risen One, you call us to believe and bear fruit. May the gifts that we offer here be signs of your abiding love. Form us to be your witnesses in the world through Jesus Christ, our true vine. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
Blessed are you, O God of the universe. Your mercy is everlasting, and your faithfulness endures from age to age. Praise to you for creating the heavens and the earth. Praise to you for saving the earth from the waters of the flood. Praise to you for bringing the Israelites safely through the sea. Praise to you for leading your people through the wilderness to the land of milk and honey. Praise to you for the words and deeds of Jesus, your anointed one. Praise to you for the death and resurrection of Christ, and praise to you for your spirit poured out on all nations. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." With this bread and cup, we remember our Lord's Passover from death to life as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. O God of resurrection and new life, pour out your Holy Spirit on us and on these gifts of bread and wine. Bless this feast. Grace our table with your presence. Come, Holy Spirit. Reveal yourself to us in the breaking of the bread. Raise us up as the body of Christ for the world. Breathe new life into us. Send us forth, burning with justice, peace, and love.
Come, Holy Spirit.
With your holy ones of all times and places, with the earth and all its creatures, with sun and moon and stars, we praise you, O God, blessed and holy Trinity, now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. This is Christ's table. All are welcome. The risen Christ is made known to us in the breaking of the bread. Come and eat at God's table.
Thank you.
And if you feel comfortable holding the person's hand next to you, please do. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Shepherding God, you have prepared a table before us and nourished us with your love. Send us forth from this banquet to proclaim your goodness and share the abundant mercy of Jesus, our Redeemer and friend. Amen. I have a few announcements for you today. VBS registration is open, and you can do it online or sign a paper. This is for adults as well as children. We've had meetings. It's going to be the Hero Hotline. You don't want to miss it. It has something to offer for all of you. So please sign up. It's June 2nd through the 6th, and then the great church picnic on June 9th at Allmiller Park for everybody. We are, again, hosting the Cardinal Chorale Choir. This is a traveling group of young high school and college students. They travel all around for a week singing, being beautiful musicians, and we need to house them on Tuesday night, June 11th. You only have them less than 10 hours. You pick them up at 9 o'clock. You have to have them back to the church by 8. If you have a work problem, I'll be here at 7. We'll feed them breakfast. We just need a place for them to sleep and shower. So if you could open up your homes, we have about 20 more people that we have to house. So please pray on that and let us know. Also, next Sunday is Pentecost, so wear red. And I invite you to attend the funeral for Charlie Dirkscheide, who is to be celebrated on Wednesday at 11 o'clock here in the sanctuary. And along with celebrations, today is Sarah Gebhardt's birthday, and so we will sing Happy Birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
And hear the blessing. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia.
The God of resurrection power, the Christ of unending joy, and the Spirit of Easter hope bless you now and always. Amen. Amen. People of good hope, we are grounded in faith, gathered in love, and sent with a purpose so that others may gain the kingdom. And we send you out singing, Crown Him with Many Crowns.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Go in peace. Rejoice and be glad.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.